are social media short videos like Vine and Instagram and GIFs becoming more relevant to the work that you do and the content you produce?
Well, at VH1, we exist in a realm of popular culture. We're not really an information delivering source. We deliver entertainment to people. And, as people's attention spans get fractured and pulled in lots of different directions, be that, the infinite universe of cable television channels or the even more infinite universe of entertainment options you have on your mobile device, be it your phone, your iPad, what have you, there's lots of people competing for your attention. And because people are spending their time in lots of these different little areas, you need to proactively go out and market your content and market your shows and market your channel and market your editorial work to people where they are. And so, probably 15 or so years ago, television was strictly interested in the push. And now we're really interested in the pull. We want to go to where people are and put out messages that are fun and unique, and we'll grab those people, like I said, in the places where they're sort of playing. And depending on where people see video, people have different sorts of expectations for what's going to happen in those sorts of fields. And, when you're working in a space like Tumblr, for example, sort of the common cultural lexicon there are animated GIFs. So, you want to speak to an audience in a space in a way that they're used to consuming content. So the same goes for Instagram video or Vine video or short bursts of information, you really just want to be able to get your point across clearly and effectively. And like I said, understand the user behavior in these different places where people congregate and spend their time, and understand how to and test and refine the way that you speak to people in those mediums.